3.10, mean approximations and differentials. We have talked about mean approximations, and now we're going to talk about differentials. Recall that if y is equal to f of x, then dy dx and f prime of x both represent the derivative of the function with respect to x. But today, we can actually regard this dy and dx here as differentials. And let's look at the details. Here's the graph for the function y equal to f of x. Here's the tangent line of this curve at this point P. The change in x over here is delta x. It's a small change in x, and we can also regard this as dx. The change of y along this curve is this delta y. That is the change of y along this curve of the function. The change of y along this tangent line, let's denote that dy. The slope of this tangent line over here, if we look at this right triangle here, it's going to be rise over run, which is going to be dy over dx over here. On the other hand, we also know that the derivative of this tangent at this point P is equal to the derivative of this function f evaluated at x over here, which is f prime of x. So the derivative of the tangent is f prime of x, and it is also this rise over run, which is dy dy by dx. So these two quantities are equal to each other. So today, we can regard this dy and dx here as differential, and we can solve for dy by multiplying both sides of this equation by this differential dx. So we have dy is equal to f prime of x times the differential dx over here. So the differential dy is defined in terms of dx by this equation. Notice that the differential dx is a small change in x that's the same as delta x. The differential dy is the change of y along the tangent line from here to here. And delta y is the change of y along the curve from here to here. This is the exact change of y of the function. For this differentiable curve, when delta x here is small, which means when delta x approaches the zero, then we can use this differential dy to approximate this exact change in y, which means we can use this change of y along the tangent line to approximate the change of y along the curve. Example, if y is equal to f of x and equal to x cubed plus x squared minus 2x plus 1, let's compare delta y with dy when x changes from 2 to 2.01. Let's first find delta y. Remember that delta y is the exact change of y along the curve of the function. So delta y is equal to f of 2.01 minus f of 2. Substituting 2.01 into x into this function and substituting 2 into x into this function. And now we take the difference of this two function value, and it turned out to be 0.140701. Now let's compute the differential dy. Remember that the differential dy is f prime of x times the differential dx. The dx here is the same as delta x. It's a change of x. In this case, x change from 2 to 2.01. So dx or delta x is equal to 0.01. When x equal to 2 and dx equal to 0.01, dy will be equal to f prime of 2 times 0.01. The derivative of this function here is 3x squared plus 2x minus 2. So we're going to substitute x equal to 2 into x. Now do the calculation. We get the differential dy is equal to 0.14. Notice that delta y is approximately equal to dy. In this figure, we have a comparison of the differential dy, this pink one over here. That's a change along the tangent line, and the exact change of y, which is the blue highlighted one here, which is the exact change of y along this curve. And the approximation becomes better as delta x becomes smaller. And notice also, dy is easier to compute than delta y. Sometimes, for more complicated function, it may be impossible to compute delta y exactly. And at that time, the approximation by differential will be very helpful.